Oh my.
This is news bulletin worthy.
I've had to make you run to the parking lot and drag her back in here.
Okay. Councilwoman Livette Fuller is back in the studio. Want her reaction on this.
I'm checking my email. I don't see it.
A couple of seconds past 8 o'clock, an email from Councilman Jerry Bowman.
Mm-hmm. It's a lengthy email, but I'll read you the final sentence. Because this is the
now, Mr. Jerry is the not the president.
He's the chairman.
The chairman of the city council, mm-hmm. which means what?
It means if the mayor is incapacitated or is not in town, Bowman acts as mayor pro tem in his stead.
So, what kind of power does that give him? It means like he's the VP when the president's on gas.
They don't do much.
When his mom was mayor pro tem, she fired a department head.
You're right. When Cedric was in the hospital that time when he got hurt, there was some action that was taken while he was in the hospital.
Okay, back to Jerry Bowman.
This is the final words, the final sentences of his statement that he sent out to a few of the members of the media today. In my opinion, based on all these factors, it would be imprudent to exclude Chief Ben Raymond as a candidate for the permanent position of Chief of Police. I wholeheartedly believe and agree that this selection is that of the mayor and not a political fight, but a fight for public safety. Therefore, in order to assure the continuity in this fight for public safety, as Mayor Pro Tem, I am including Chief Raymond as a candidate for the permanent position of Chief of Police for the City of Shreveport. Signed, Councilman Jerry Bowman Jr.
So, Jerry Bowman, who is sort of the acting mayor mm-hmm. in Mayor Perkins' absence, has said, you know what we need to do? Because honestly, Aaron read the whole email, and about 75% of that email...
It's on keelnews.com if you want to see the whole thing.
...is, no disrespect intended, sucking up to Ben Raymond and what a great job he's done.
Uh-huh.
But Jerry was on the committee.
And I just emailed Jerry, and I said, did you even vote for him? Because we're told that Ben Raymond got 3 votes.
Right now, if everybody who says they
now
voted
for... Now 4 people say they voted for him.
If everybody who says they voted for Ben Raymond actually voted for Ben Raymond, he would have been one of the 3 finalists.
Yes.
I want to chime in here.
Please.
This is why it's important to know exactly what the process was. Like, irrefutably, this is what the process was. This is the way the ballots were handled. These are the people that had access to the ballot, to the ballots. This is how they were counted. All of that.
Okay, so I have a question for the collective, as it were.
Am I crazy for expecting that?
No, I'm with you.
Jerry Bowman, the interim mayor.
Mayor pro tem.
When Adrian's out of town, adds Ben Raymond to the list of finalists.
Mm-hmm.
On his own. Oh, wait, does he? Ladies, do you think...
God, he's long-winded.
Do you think that Mayor Perkins, on his way out of town, said to Jerry Bowman, I got an idea. When I'm out of town, let's sort of tamp down this chief of police fire. When I'm out of town, I want
when
you.
When it's just you and me here, the questions go a lot faster. No, I don't think that's what happened. I do not think that they're plotting against the city.
So you don't think that the mayor knew leaving town that Mr. Bowman was going to do this?
I'm not going to speculate. But even if it was something he did, I don't think that he did it like in a menacing, weird, like Mr. Burns on Simpsons way. I think that maybe they did have that conversation, but...
In other words...
They could have had the conversation, but the thing is, Jerry might have prayed about it and woke up this morning and decided this is what he wants to do, and he is that person.
Since there's no evidence one way or the other, we can only assume that Jerry did it on his own?
Well, you know what they say when you assume...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what I'm going to say is I believe because Jerry keeps counsel. He deliberates and he's a pretty solid person.
But Jerry didn't say.
And
he just said,
maybe vote together like 10% of the time.
He just said he was going to do it. He didn't say that he was not doing it
it's within his rights as mayor pro tem to do that. Just like it's the prerogative of the mayor to make his selection. We all as a council have to confirm it.
I think Jerry probably prayed about it,
meditated on it, and decided, well, wait a minute, I can do this while I have this position.
Let me approach this from a different direction. So do you think when the mayor gets back, he's going to go, Jerry, what the hell did you do?
And scratch Raymond's name off.
I'm not going to speculate about that stuff. See, y'all,
are you
listen,
happy? Are you happy that he did this?
I think that it's within his rights to do it. And
does Ben Raymond belong on that list?
If I were in the same position, I'm not sure what I would do.
But does Ben belong on the list?
I will tell you what my people have said. And this is the thing. I like Ben Raymond. Actually, I won't even tell you what my people have said. I'm going to go back to what I've been saying. I want to know what the process was. I want to know if there was a rubric. I want to know how we weighted the test versus the interview versus the resume. And if I have all that information and see what those scores are and that it's objective, then okay, I can accept the three we have. If not, then everything goes back up in the air. Is that fair?
Well, mm-hmm. This sort of puts everything back up in the air, though, doesn't it? I mean, what is, once again, for the collective? So what do you think Mayor Perkins is going to do when he gets back?
I don't think we can speculate about that. If I wanted to play those kinds of games, I would go be on The Real Housewives of something.
There's also,
which could be fun, The Real Housewives of Highland.
There's also council rules that I mistakenly said was in the charter. It's council rules of procedure that the mayor has to get his name to you guys in writing 2 weeks before it can be put on an agenda.
That's my understanding. And I don't know if that means we have to file some sort of extension, because if we've got till the 29th to have a name, because it's 60 days from July 31st, but we can't confirm anyone mm-hmm. for 2 weeks, we're going to need some sort of whatever.
But yet the civil service rules seem to say just the opposite, that a chief has to be, what is it, 60 days?
That's what she's saying. She's saying that she's wanting to ask an extension.
I think we're going to have to ask for an extension, because we can't break the charter.
Yeah, which rules come first, civil service rules or your rules for the city?
I think that we have to get an extension, probably.
Okay.
We basically defer to our city. This is why we have our city attorney. We have the attorney general. We might have to get outside counsel from our people.
Quickly, you had solicited both the city attorney, Ms. Creel, mm-hmm. and the attorney general of Louisiana, Mr. Landry. Did you hear back from either of them?
Ms. Creel told me, though, that's not in the charter, that's simply rules of the council, and they can vote to suspend the rules to add the name. It has to be unanimous, but they can vote to suspend the rules and add the name. One more question.
You got 40 seconds.
I know. Lavette Fuller, does this action by Mayor Pro Tem Bowman surprise you today?
Well, I mean, yeah. I mean, I was just getting a flu shot and minding my own business, and like, then you tell me that you got this email. So I'm a little surprised. But yeah, I mean, yeah, I'm surprised.